In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly King, Paraclete, Spirit of Truth, present everywhere and filling all things, treasury of blessings and giver of life, come dwell within us and cleanse us of every stain, and all good ones save our souls. Amen. Hi, and thank you for joining me on another meditation of the Psalms of the Byzantine Daily Office. Today we're looking at Psalm 90 in the Greek numbering, Psalm 91 in the Hebrew numbering. It's the third psalm in the sixth hour of the day. I cannot read this psalm without hearing the song that will make many of my Roman Rite friends cringe, and probably a few of my Byzantine Rite ones, and maybe the reason a few of us left the Catholic Church at some point. But I will raise you up on eagle's wings and bear you on the breath of dawn. I first heard that song in what is a completely appropriate context. It was not a Catholic Mass or, God save us, a Roman Catholic funeral, but rather an Episcopal Church youth gathering where we were singing around a campfire with guitars. There's an appropriate place for such music, and there's a completely inappropriate place for such music, but a campfire is an appropriate place. It's that song is a meditation on this psalm. God promises to take care of us and to raise us up. And when I read this psalm, and I really suggest that you do too, read it directly, what I notice is how the pronouns shift back and forth. There's actually three different voices in this psalm. There's the person speaking who says, "You, Lord, are my hope." Then God is actually speaking, for God says, "I am with him," in the third person. So God is with the speaker of this psalm, whom God says in the third person. And then there's somebody who seems to address the speaker, sort of, if you will, a counter voice to a second speaker in the psalm who addresses the one. So the speaker says, "He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shade or the protection of the God of heaven. He will do the following things. He will do this." And then God says, "I will do the following things because he knows who I am." And then the speaker says, "I know you, God, and you will do these things for me." So there are three voices here. And if you read this psalm, you can imagine it as a priestly blessing where the narrator, if you will, is saying, "The one who trusts God will be blessed." And the person being blessed says, "I trust God." And then a liturgical choir, I guess, takes on the voice of God and sings back, "I promise I will do these things for you." So there are three voices in this psalm: a blessing voice, a blessed voice, and a blesser voice. And it's wonderful to hear not only God promising to take care of those whom he loves, not only to hear the faith of King David accepting God's blessing, but to hear the liturgy of the temple, the first temple, of a priestly blessing and a layperson's reception of that blessing, and I guess a Levite choir singing behind the curtain. Right? It is such a wonderful psalm. And we say it in the middle of the day at noonish, and we also say it at Compline at night. And we say it at both small Compline and at great Compline, sorry. it's such a wonderful psalm to hear and such a consolation to the heart. And so read the psalm and understand that even if thousands are falling at your right and 10,000s are falling beside you, God is holding you in the palm of his hand, and his angels are taking care of you lest you dash your foot against a stone. God is with you in a time of trouble, and he will rescue you and glorify you and fill you with length of days and show you salvation. It is truly meet to bless you, the Theotokos, ever blessed and most blameless and the mother of our God, more honorable than the cherubim and beyond compare more glorious than the seraphim. Without corruption, you gave birth to God the Word. Truly, the Theotokos, we magnify you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.